video of a lot of images and some videos from the time that Sandy's been with us, and I think some video from the party Friday night as well. So he is going to share with us the video.
Tears in your eyes as Jesus took your hand. You stood before the Lord. He said, "My child, look around you. Great is your
change. Thank you for giving.
friends of Boulder City United Methodist Church for the love that you have shown me while I have ministered among you. I thank you for the blessings that we have shared together. I thank you for the laughters and the tears. I'm grateful for the ways that my leadership has been accepted, and I ask for forgiveness for the mistakes that I've made. As I leave, I carry with me all that I have learned here. And if you'll say, we receive
your thankfulness, offer forgiveness, and accept that you now lead Minister Santa Cruz family, UMC. We express our gratitude for your time among us. We ask for your forgiveness for our mistakes, your influence on our faith and your faithfulness. And I believe in your future.
Dear ones, I accept your gratitude and forgiveness, and I forgive you, trusting that our time together and our parting are pleasing to God. I release you from turning to me and depending on me. I encourage your continuing ministry here, and I will pray for you and for your new pastor, Reverend Michael E. If you'll join me in prayer. Eternal God, whose steadfast love for us is from everlasting to everlasting, we give you thanks for cherished memories and commitment to your care as we move in new directions. Keep us one in your love forever, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Okay, we have a little story to tell here. I may not have all the times right, but she can correct me if I have them wrong. As she said earlier, she said, came to us in 2012 as a local pastor, still continuing her education in seminary. And as the first year was coming to an end, we knew that she was going to be commissioned into the United Methodist Church. So several of us decided a very fitting gift would be a stole. So I was designated to make the stole. So I made this stole for Sandy with lots of love. And before sewing it closed, we brought it to church many Sundays in a row for anybody and everybody to write a blessing, a message for Sandy. And it's full. It is full of those blessings. So we gave it to her when she was commissioned and found out, you can't wear a stole till you're ordained.
It was the best gift.
But she had 2 extra years that she could have it with her with all our blessings inside it before she finally was able to wear it when she was ordained. We send it with her now. You will always have our blessings with you. Where do you go?
And I have a gift for all of you. How many are sewers in the room? A few people. So you know how with most sewing projects, sometimes you get part of it done, but not all of it done? Am I the only one?
No.
So if you'll notice here, I made altar runners. I made this one first because I wanted it for Pentecost, and then I forgot all about it. And I was here at the end of worship 2 weeks ago going, darn it. So I finished the red one and the white one. There's a purple and a green, of course, our liturgical colors, which I promise I'll finish. I can't leave until they're done. And I will bring them here, but I leave these as a gift from my heart to yours. And hopefully you'll remember when you see it on the altar that I'm always with you. All right, that's just about enough of all this mushy stuff.